Welcome to the IPPS-A Commanders Course. In this installment of the video series, we will cover the Manager Self-Service homepage in IPPS-A. Please note, in IPPS-A, all commanders are considered managers, and soldiers are considered members. Throughout this course, we will refer to soldiers as members because that is the terminology used by the Oracle PeopleSoft system. PeopleSoft is the software that runs IPPS-A. Both commanders and managers have access to review and approve personnel actions and special pay requests, and view a member's profile information. A commander has additional access to view data on their assigned soldiers related to physical information, restrictions, and talent. Only commanders can update flags, perform decentralized promotions, and approve HR action requests. Readiness reports provide duty status history, not present for duty, and unit pulleys information. Readiness reports also allow commanders or their designees to perform duty status queries. The system allows for the creation of ad hoc reports, which are available to select HR professionals with certain roles and permissions. All of this is done from IPPS-A's Manager Self-Service homepage. Once you are signed in, click in the Self-Service drop-down menu to access the Manager Self-Service dashboard. This is your homepage for all commander duties. You can personalize this page by adding, deleting, or moving tiles. We will go over customizing your dashboard in the personalization video. From the Manager Self-Service page, you can access the different applications within IPPS-A and navigate through the system using the five icons in the top right corner. Let's take a moment to explain these icons, starting with the Home icon. The Home icon will always return you to the Manager Self-Service homepage. Next is the Global Search icon, which looks like a magnifying glass. This is a search tool that lets you narrow in on the page you are looking for using keyword searches. Next in the line is the notification icon, which looks like a flag. This shows you alerts and notifications of actions that need your approval. Then there is the action list icon, the three vertical dots. This is where you will personalize your homepage, set your preferences, search training products that will help you understand the system, and sign out. Lastly, there is the Nav Bar icon, which looks like a compass. You will use this to navigate to different areas in IPPS-A through a set of menu paths that open on the right side of the screen. Now, let's quickly take a look at the different tiles available to you on your homepage. The Duty Status History tile allows you to view your soldiers' duty statuses. The Special Pay Request tile is where HR professionals can create, start, and stop certain incentive pays, which then require approval by you, the commander. Special Pay Request is a dedicated application tile that displays the incentive pays page. An HR professional can create and submit a special pay request via the workflow process. This process follows the same workflow as other personnel action requests, or PARs, in IPPS-A. Next, let's open the Promotion Rosters tile. This tile launches the Decentralized Promotion Roster page. IPPS-A standardizes the decentralized promotion process in Release 2 and provides a framework for states to do semi-centralized and centralized promotions. We will explore decentralized promotions further in the Promotions and Flags video. Moving on to the View Orders tile. This tile allows commanders to filter orders based on what they want to see, such as military rank, UIC, order type, or date range. IPPS-A produces 11 order types in Release 2. These are covered in the workflow video. The results of the search populate based on the search criteria entered. The View File column will display the member's order page. The Approvals tile displays the number of actions which require your approval. From here, you can view and access your pending approvals by type and category. We will cover approvals in more detail in the workflow video. The Not Present for Duty tile shows a list of soldiers not present for duty and their leave status description. The list provides details such as the member duty status, who updated the member duty status, and the timestamp of when the update took place. This is a good example of traceability and auditability that IPPS-A provides. This report can also be downloaded as an Excel spreadsheet, CSV text file, or XML file. The Duty Status Query tile displays as a downloadable spreadsheet of your soldier's duty status. You can see the current duty status along with the predefined statuses such as ready for drill, approved absence, and administrative absence. The system displays the following duty statuses for Army National Guard members: ready for drill, approved absence, and administrative absence. The unit pulleys tile will take you to a list of all unit members based on their physical profiles. Here, you can see reporting on a member's physical profile. The profiles display the six pulleys factors along with their numeric designators. The Human Resources Authorization Report, or HARAR, visually displays your unit's manning. The HARAR was formerly called the Unit Manning Report, or UMR. We will be covering the HARAR in a later video. The Predefined Queries tile allows you to view various reports, which include information on service data, soldier availability and restriction, unit vacancies, demographics, deployment history, promotion information, certifications, personnel management, and annual records review. Let's move on to the Profile Management tile. This tile provides commanders a means to make more informed talent management decisions in their units. In here, commanders can see skills, competencies, accomplishments, and responsibilities of all soldiers in their unit. In Release 2, 13 tabs within the profiles will be active. These tabs include the following: career management, qualifications, education, licenses and certifications, awards and decorations, aviation, language and civilian employment, assignment information, physical profiles, benefits, security information, and service data. You and your HR professionals have access to view and update select fields within these tabs. As with all areas of IPPS-A, these updates are auditable and require the proper documents or authoritative data sources. A significant change that IPPS-A will bring to the Army is the automation of personnel action requests, or PARs. PARs will replace the DA Form 4187. The HR Personnel Action Request tile launches the HR PAR dashboard, which allows you to view and approve PARs. As a commander, you can easily create new PARs. Although it is unlikely that you will create PARs, you do have the capability to do so. Submitting a PAR is covered in the self-service course. There are 11 PARs in Release 2. Some PARs, once approved, will automatically update a member's record and produce the applicable order. We will cover orders in the workflow video of this series. The Commander Board Preferences tile is used for semi-centralized and centralized promotion boards. Commanders can review soldier preferences and make or change preferences on behalf of the soldier. The Team Learning tile provides the commander with a list of IPPS-A-related training information for their direct reports. This tile displays only IPPS-A-related training programs. As a commander, you can enroll your direct reports into IPPS-A training. The Assignments tile takes you to the Assignment Coordination and Tracking module, or ACT, within IPPS-A. The ACT module is your one-stop shop for assignments, to include both temporary and permanent assignments. Transactions include arrivals, departures, and conditional releases. From here, you can create a conditional release assignment for your direct reports, see flags, and view assignment histories for your soldiers. The ACT module also provides commanders with the ability to build reports with certain parameters and filters. From the ACT module, commanders can view projected losses, projected gains, and vacancies. That was just a quick overview of what each of the tiles is used for. Don't worry, we will dive into each tile further in the rest of the video series. This concludes our video on self-service homepage in IPPS-A. The next video will show you how to personalize your homepage. IPPS-A will soon be the new standard in all HR actions, and you need to fully understand its capabilities. Stay with us through the series for step-by-step instructions on specific tasks within the IPPS-A system. IPPS-A is here. One soldier, one record, one Army.